In this course, we will learn how to use Perforce Helix Core through both P4V and Unreal Engine. Before we dive in, it is important to understand some basic principles about how Helix Core works across these different environments. As we learned in the last course, the log at the bottom of the P4V interface displays a running list of all Helix Core commands given through P4V. Whenever you interact with a file through P4V, for example, by right-clicking on a file and checking it out, P4V translates this action into a text command that is sent to the server and displayed on the log pane. The result of these actions are displayed visually in P4V. Note, there may be times when it is advantageous to right-click in the log pane and choose the Clear Log action to get a more concise view of the commands that P4V is sending to the server. At the most basic level, these text commands could also be typed directly into a command prompt window, the P4 client, bypassing the need for the P4V visual client altogether. The P4V visual client provides a more intuitive way of displaying and performing the same commands that can be done in a command prompt. P4V does the translating for you. Other applications with a Perforce Helix Core integration, such as Unreal Engine, operate using the same principles as P4V, translating actions and clicks within the application into text commands that are sent to the Helix Core server. With this in mind, you can use your preferred application to interact with the Helix Core Depot. Whether you check out an asset with P4V or Unreal Engine, the action of checking out the asset is translated to the same text command that is sent to the server. Therefore, the choice depends on preference and the task at hand. It is important to note that not every command may be available in every application. There are some things that can only be done via the command line and not P4V. And there are many things that can be done in P4V, but not in Unreal Engine. This is by design and serves to simplify the user experience by not introducing lots of buttons and menu options where they do not need to be. For example, most of the commands in Unreal Engine focus on interacting with project assets, allowing you to check out, submit, and sync files manually and/or automatically with the Unreal Engine application.